Okay, I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm late.
Okay, Mr. Aurita, no problem. The clear time and Zoom screen is yours.
Okay, thank you. Okay, anyone want to show their works before we move on? Anyone? Simulation is okay.
But mine was quite strange, the result. Can you just check it, Pak?
Okay. Please share your screen.
All right. Share screen, right? And let me check another one. Give me a second. Oops. Is it this one or which one? Sketching.
Okay.
So when I don't know how, maybe the secret, do you think, or I will try to. Okay, I will simulate then, and then this is the result.
Result is default to zero because you don't turn the knob of the potentiometer.
So which one that I should
No, you stop the simulation.
Okay, this one.
And then put the potentiometer to higher position so you can control it.
Yeah, here.
Drag to the higher place.
Drag to.
Nah, okay. And then start the simulation again.
Start simulation again.
Okay, you can try to turn the potentiometer.
Okay, wait, hold on. Should I pause or stop the simulation?
No.
I don't need it.
Yeah.
So.
The knob,
The knob,
turn
this
the,
knob? Uh-huh.
Turn to the right, yes.
So, is it enough?
Yes, it's enough.
Uh-huh, and then?
The value in the serial monitor should be changed. You could scroll to the bottom.
Read.
Serial monitor in the bottom.
Nah.
Oh, no, scroll it in the bottom.
Where is the serial monitor?
You can stop the simulation. Stop.
Okay, stop.
And then... You can press the delete button in the bottom right.
Right, bottom right, wait.
The recycle bin.
Recycle bin, wait, hold on.
The full bottom right in the screen.
Full button right?
Bottom
here?
Right. Bottom right.
Bottom right.
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 The recycle bin button, the trash button.
The trash button? Where's the trash button here?
In the bottom right of the screen, of your screen.
My screen.
Yeah, the browser.
But I should click on something then.
No. And the circuit is okay.
Oh, okay. The circuit is okay. So here
you can scroll it to scroll bar. Yes, scroll to the bottom.
So this one. Do you mean this one?
Yes. You can clear the output.
So just click on that.
Yeah.
Okay,
and then you can start again the simulation.
And then
the value will be printed in the below 2000. You can turn the knob and the value will be different.
Okay. But it means that I'm already on the right.
Yes, way. you are in the right path.
Oh my god. That's really okay then. So all right.
Okay. Thank
you. I will unscreen then. Thank you, sir.
You're welcome. Okay. Sorry. Share screen. Anyone want to share their works? No? Okay, I will continue the guide. Okay, the potentiometer, the basic principle is voltage divider. So potentiometer is variable resistor. You can change the resistor value by turning the knob. So it acts as a voltage divider. So when you turn it to full left, the voltage will be zero. And if you turn to the full right, the voltage will be maximum VCC. Okay, in VMOS D1, the resolution of analog input is 10 bit. So you will have the value from 0 to 1000, 1024. In ESP32 has higher resolution, 12 bit. So you will have the value from 0 to 4096. Okay, this is the basic voltage divider. Full screen. Okay, I will zoom. The voltage from the source is 10 volt. If you see here, the voltage is 10 volt. And you have resistor 10K and 10K, then the middle voltage is 5 volt in the middle. In case of potentiometer, we can change the value of the resistor to resistors, the top and bottom. For example, if we change this to say 5K, okay, and then the voltage will be higher, 6.7. If we change this to 1K, and the voltage is higher. This is 1 per 11, and below is 10 per 11. So the value is 10 per 11. Okay, for potentiometer, we can change the value of the resistance by moving the knob up or down. Okay. Another example, this is 20, then the voltage will be 1/3, the 10 per 30, the total of the resistance. Okay, this is voltage divider. The voltage will be varying by the resistance. We will continue in the guide. Okay, practice. We can use a potentiometer to adjust the brightness of the LED using analog right. All the pin of the PMOS D1 can be used to output the analog value, analog right, except pin D0. If you check the pin out, all digital pin can output analog output except D0. So we will use D4. It is okay for outputting analog output. Potentiometer. Okay. In a previous example, we changed the blinking duration. In this practice, we will use the potentiometer value from 0 to 1000 to control the brightness of LED on pin D4. For analog right, we can write the value between 0 to 255 because the resolution is 8-bit. In contrast with the digital right can only high or low 0 volt or VCC 3.3 volt. With analog right, we can write in between 0 and VCC. The value between 0 and 255. 0 is 0 volt, 255 is 3.3 volt. If you want to write 1 volt, you can calculate it yourself. 1 volt is the value is calculate it yourself. Okay. We only need to adjust the value of analog read. This is 10 bit to the value of analog write. This is 8 bit. So from the value, we will divide it by 4. 1024 divided by 4 will be 256. So the code is the same. The difference is we will use analog write. Analog write. The value can be from 0 to 255. Okay, I will copy in this code to Sketch, to Arduino IDE. And then the digital write replaced by analog write. Okay, the value is from potentiometer. So we have 10 bit value from 0 to 1024. This is from 0 to 124. But in the analog write function, it only accept from 0 to 256 or minus 1, yeah. 255, this is 1023. So before we write the actual value, we must divide it by 4, like this. This is not needed, so we only write the value from potentiometer divided by 4. The delay, we use static delay, 100 milliseconds. Okay, and the faster delay, the faster the response. So if you want faster response by turning the knob, directly affect the light, you may use faster delay to get the faster response from the MCU. Because the MCU is looping in here, so the MCU will read, will sampling the reading every 50 milliseconds in this example. Okay, if you use ESP32, the value will be from 0 to 4000. And the analog write is the same from 0 to 255. So you must divide it by 4 by 4, 16. If you use ESP32. Okay. We will try that in simulation. Okay, this is the code for the exercise using analog write. You can see in the documentation for analog write in Arduino website, analog write. Analog write. Okay, and the value is between 0 to 255. So we must divide the value from analog input. Okay, this is the program, and then we will upload it to the MCU. Okay, and then we will check the result. Okay, where is my screwdriver? Okay, if I turn to the left, it will be dimmer like this, but cannot be dim. If I turn it to the right, it will be brighter to some extent because the camera cannot cannot see the difference if it is too dim or too bright. Okay, you can see the opposite in the built-in LED for ESP8266. This is low, turn off to the right, and to the left will be brighter because the built-in LED is the opposite, active low. Okay, this analog right. Then we can try in the simulation by adjusting the pin and the divisor. The delay is static. If you want faster response, you set faster delay. And then we use analog write to control the brightness of the LED. And then the value will be divided by 16. 4000 divided by 16, 250. Okay, from the common, this is 0 to 4000, and analog write is 0 to 256 minus 1. So we must divide it by 16. Okay, we'll try in the simulation. And you can see the difference. This is turn off, and then dimmer, brighter, brighter, brighter. Okay, when we set it to 0, it is the same as digital write low, 0. And if we set it to maximum, it is the same as digital write high. But we are using analog write, we can set the value in between. Okay. Okay, any question for this analog write? Okay, no question. Okay, we'll continue to light sensor, LDR. LDR is light dependent resistor. This is a resistor, so polarity doesn't matter. You can change the direction. And then the value of the resistance is depend on the brightness of the surrounding light. So LDR has a glass covering that will change the resistance value. Okay, this is the LDR. Sorry, focus. Okay. It has two pins. It is the same as the resistor, but the value will be varying depending on the light condition. Okay. Because the MCU cannot read the resistance value, we will hook up the LDR with the resistor, with another resistor, to form a voltage divider circuit. So the voltage will be from VCC to the LDR, one resistor, and then in series with 10K resistor to the ground, and we read the middle voltage value. If the LDR value is changing, the voltage in the middle will be changed also. So the basic is using voltage divider. We read the varying voltage. Okay, and the program is the same as the potentiometer. So we read using analog read in pin A0, the LDR value. And then we output it to the serial monitor using serial communication. And then we read the value to differentiate between it is night or day to control the lamp. The threshold will depend on the condition. In this example, the threshold is 500. You should change it depend on your surrounding condition. Okay, let's hook up the LDR. So I will replace the potentiometer. Okay, for safety, you should disconnect the MCU, and then you can safely change the component. Okay, you need a higher resistor, like 10K. If you use, I have 100K even. If you use a lower value resistance, the voltage value will be near zero. So you cannot read a valuable value from that. So you should use higher value resistor. Okay, from the I will put the LDR first. This is non-polar, so doesn't matter the polarity. And then the resistor, 10K or higher in series. one column is connected, so this is connected from LDR to resistor. Series to the ground, and we read the middle voltage value. This, and we power it through VCC, 3.3 volt. Okay, then we read the value. The program is still the same. Okay, we have 570. Let me check. Clear. Okay, I will copy paste this new program and then upload. Okay, and then I will check the value for the LDR. Okay, and this is the normal lighting condition, 800 in the value, and when I close the LDR, 200. So the middle value is around 500. So this is right for my condition. So you should check the output for the LDR in the serial monitor. This is when the lighting is on, around 800. And when I close it with my finger, 300. So the threshold may be around 500. So if I check it in the MCU, this is normal. Lighting condition normal in the daylight, for example. And then when the night comes, the lamp will be light up. Okay. Okay. The basic is using voltage divider. Okay, for the simulation, you should use LDR. Where is LDR? LDR.
Foto.
Foto resistor, okay. Okay, and this is LDR module. So you have two outputs. Okay. VCC, ground, and two output, digital output and analog output. This is LDR module. Whereas in my case, LDR component. So in this module is complete. So you have resistor in this area for voltage divider, and then you have comparator. So you can have digital output by controlling the potentiometer knob. Okay. For this example, we will use the analog output. So VCC to 3.3 and then ground to background. Okay, the cabling is messy, and then analog output to PP. Okay, and then paste the code like this. The LDR value will be from 0 to 4000, so the threshold may be wrong, but we try it. Pin mode, pin number 2, digital red pin number 2, number 2, A0 to 36, pin 36, simulate. Nah, we can control it using slider in the simulation. Okay, when the value is below 500, the lamp will be on. Or it is. It is opposite, maybe. Yeah. Zero lux is dark, yeah. And I have reading maybe 100 lux is 2000. Okay, I will change the code. When the value is higher than 2000, then turn on the LED. Now, the LDR module in this simulation is the opposite. If the value is high, it is dark. If the value is low, then it is light. So the opposite. It is dark, the LED is turned on. If it is in the daylight, the LED is turned off. Okay, you should check the output of the analog read value. Why and the value is the opposite? Because this arrangement. If the resistor is in the front and the LDR is in the back, then the value will be in the opposite. If we change the placement, the value will be opposite. Okay, so you should check the value from the LDR to determine the threshold value and the comparator. Higher or lower. Okay, any problem or any question? Can I track the cable? No. Okay, in the simulation, you can position the cable by clicking it like this, and then there will be two dots. You can change the position by dragging these dots. Nah. Okay, we continue to button as digital input. For digital input, the input must be high or low. It cannot be unconnected. So if the button is pressed, then the output in this schematic will be low, because from D5, the button will be read. The state of the button will be read by pin D5 as input. If the button is pressed, then it is connected to ground, from D5 to ground. The button connecting the left side to the right side. But when the button is not pressed, it will be unconnected. Nah, unconnected is not low, is not high. So in the middle, we call it floating. This will make the MCU unstable, because the value will be changed rapidly between high and low. So we must pull it to the VCC, or pull it to the ground when the button is not pressed. Okay, in this example, this is active low. If the button is pressed, then the input will be low. If the button is unpressed, we want to make this button high. So we use input pull up. Input pull up. We set the pin mode to input pull up. When the button is not pressed, it is default to high, to up. Okay, so the state of the button will be only two, a high or low. Low when it is pressed, high when it is unpressed. Okay, this is the circuit schematic. If the button is pressed, the input to D5 will be low. So this button is active low. If it is active, the input will be low. Okay, for the example, if the button is pressed, so we check if the button is high or low. If it is low, then the LED will flash 5 times. The times, we can change it. In this example, the LED will flash 5 times. For the connection, LED to D4. This is pin mode output to the LED. And the negative to ground via resistor. And then for the input, button pin 1 in the left to D5, pin 2 in the right to ground. Okay, this is the program. Okay, we use definition to simplify our code. So we use LED to as an alias for pin D4, pin LED, and pin button as an alias for pin D5. And then in the setup, we set the LED as output, pin LED, and then pin button as input pull up. When the button is inactive, the value will be high, pull up. Okay, in the loop, we check the button using digital read. The value will be high or low, digital read. And we check if it is pressed, that is active low. If it is low, then we run this code for 5 times from E0 to E5, E++. This is the increment. This is the initialization from E0. And then the maximum counting to 5. And the increment is plus 1. So this will be run for 5 times. Okay, in the loop, we will set the LED high and low with delay of 1 second, four or five times. Okay. Okay, I will set up the breadboard first before I upload the code. Disconnect the MCU from the power, and then we remove the LDR. Okay, the LED will be the same. We will use the LED as an indicator, and we add button as an input. The button will be connected to pin D5, any pin is okay. In this example, I use pin D5. And then from button in the right side, connect it to ground. Okay, so when the button is pressed, when the button is active, it is connected to ground. Okay, when the button is inactive, it is in the unconnected state, high impedance, high resistance. In order to avoid that, we use mode input pull up. So when the button is inactive, the pin D5 input is high. Okay, the setup is complete from the breadboard. Then we continue to upload the program. Okay, press upload. Wait it until 100%. Reset. Okay, we check the result in the MCU. Okay, I will press the button, and then the LED will be flash 5 times. Okay. Okay, any question for this example? The new things is this define. We can use define to make alias for the pin, so we can read the code more clearly. Define, this is the alias, this is the original. And then there is input pull up mode. Usually we use it as a button. So the state will be high if the button is not connected. Okay, and the rest is programming construct. This is if for branching. So if the button is not pressed, this entire line of code is passed. So the MCU will loop to the beginning. Check if it press or not, if it press or not, like that. If it is press, that is active low. If it is low, then the code in the below of if construct will be executed. Okay, and this is for branching. And then we have comparison using design 2 times. equal sign 2 times for comparison. If it is 1 times, it is assignment. We assign the value of digital read button to the variable press. This is assignment, this is for comparison. Whether it is the same or not. And then we have looping construct using for. This is the initialization value. The variable in this example, we use I variable. You can use another variable. Doesn't have to be I. Like, for example, X. This is also X. This is X. Usually we use I for looping. And then start from 0 until 5. So when the counter is 5, the looping will be stopped. The increment is plus 1. This is the same as I equal I plus 1. So for the next increment, the counter will be incremented by 1. The shortcut is I plus plus. Okay, you will only need to change this value if you want change the lighting. For example, 3 times, you change the maximum value in the looping. Okay, that is for button for digital input. Slightly different. We use mode input pull up. And the button is active low. So we check for it if it is low. If it is low, then the button is pressed. Okay, for the simulation, I will copy paste this code. And then, okay. LED is pin number 2, button D5 is pin number. So check the conversion, 18. And the rest is the same. Yeah, the same. And then I add a button, push button. Connect it to pin 18. Is connected to ground. Okay, like this, and then start simulation. The LED is not light up until we press the button. Okay, it will blink 3 times. Stop. Okay, we continue to and the real sensor, temperature and humidity sensor, DHT, DHT 11. The output is digital, so we don't use analog input, A0. we use digital pin. So the output is already in digital form, in a number, not a voltage. Okay, it has, for the HT module, it has 3 pins, VCC, positive, ground, negative, and then the data. The middle pin usually in the data. I will connect it to pin D4 in this example. Okay, the connection table is like this. And for the HT, we must add library, the HT sensor library. So in the IDE, you will need to go to library manager. We will add the HT sensor library from Adafruit. So in the tools, go to manage library. Manage library. This is library manager. And then search this keyword, the HT sensor library. Okay. We have many results because this is open source. Everyone can write library, but we will use the specific library from Adafruit, by Adafruit. Okay, I will click the install button to install the DHT sensor library from Adafruit. Okay. There is a confirmation. You must click install all. So this will install all the dependency of this library. So click install all. Okay, you can check the status. If the status is installed, then it is already installed. It is installed successfully. Okay, any question regarding installing library? The menu is in tools, manage library, and then search in this box, filter your search, DHT sensor library, enter. There will be many results. You should install the library from Adafruit. In my case, this is the third row. Click install and wait until the status changes to install. Okay. Okay, in this example, we use pin D4 to read the output of DHT11, and we will read the value every 2 seconds. The value will be sent to the serial monitor. Okay, and this is the code. And I will set up the breadboard. Okay, this is the DHT11 sensor. It has 3 pins in the form of module. In the basic form, it has 4 pins. 1, 2, 3, 4. The third pin is unused. Okay. In this module, it has 3 pins plus 2 VCC and then minus 2 ground and output to one of digital pin. Okay, so you place it in the breadboard horizontally like this in different column, and then the plus to VCC sorry 0.3, and then the minus is to ground. You can hook it up directly like this, and then the data is read into pin D4 to out. Okay. And then I will upload the program to the MCU so we can read the sensor value in the serial monitor. Okay, the value will be sent to the PC by serial communication. This is the value. Okay, the first one is temperature 29 in my room, and then the second field is the humidity, relative humidity value 53 in my room. Okay, I will explain the code. So we must include the library dht.h from Adafruit. If the library is not yet installed, then the compilation will be error in this line. And then we make one variable dht. This variable name can be anything you like, so you can change it. The parameter is the pin, digital pin. We use D4, and then the type. The type is DHT11. Another type is DHT22. If you want more accurate sensor, you may use DHT22. For DHT11, the resolution is low, so you can only get the humidity in integer, so the point will be always 00, 52.00, and then if it is changed to 53.00. Okay, if you want more accurate results, use DHT22. The library is the same, just changing the type. Okay, in the setup, we set up the serial communication. Serial begin, this is the bitrate, and then we set up the sensor using DHT begin. Okay, in the loop, we will read the temperature and humidity and then save it to a variable TC, temperature in Celsius, and RH, relative humidity. And then we will print it to the serial. Print TC, and then we print comma. This is print comma, and then space, and then print the relative humidity value plus new line. So print will print as is, whereas print ln will print the variable and then new line. And lastly, delay 2 seconds. To give the time for the sensor to recovery. For DHT11, the fastest delay is 1 second. So you can only read every 1 second. Okay, this is the value in the serial monitor. So the first one is serial print TC, and then we print comma, comma space, and then we print the relative humidity value. Okay. If you want to control the point, the number, the decimal number behind the point, you can use two parameter. So R8 and then 0. So there is no decimal value. Now, the RH is in integer, no decimal value. Or maybe you want to change the format for the temperature to one decimal value, you can add TC, the second parameter, one decimal value. Okay, it become like this. Okay, this is how to control the display of the floating point format. Okay, float is floating point. We use it to store decimal value. For integer value, we use integer int as a variable type, data type. Okay. Okay, I use a comma separator because we can use serial plotter. Serial plotter. If you use comma as a separator, you can have a plot in the serial plotter. You can access it in the tools, and then below serial monitor, there is serial plotter. So it will plot the value of the temperature and relative humidity. Temperature is in this case blue in the below, and the relative humidity is red. The graph is slow because the delay is 2 seconds. So it will update every 2 seconds. You can leave it there like this, and then you can check it later. Serial plotter. Okay, any question for the DHT? You can also try it in the simulator. D4 is pin number 2, DHT11, okay, I will add the sensor, DHT11, search, oh, they only have DHT22, okay, and this is the actual component, so it has 4 pin. Okay, and then we should change the type to DHT22. VCC connect it to 3.3 volt, ground to ground, and then data pin to pin number 2. Okay. SDA is serial data pin. The third pin is NC, not connected. We don't use this pin. And then simulate, start simulation. You can check the value in the serial monitor. Okay, the value is none, not a number. What's wrong? It's from library manager. Okay, no library install. Okay, and this is the sketch, the program, and we use DHT library. In WalkWe, we have library manager. So maybe we should install the library first, DHT. Sensor library. Okay, type the name of the library. As in the guide, DHT sensor library. So we have it installed. Okay, we try to run it again. Okay, still doesn't work. DHT, CC, SDA, D2, down. DHT sensor library. Okay, still doesn't work for my case for DHT22. Pin number 2, DHT22. But don't worry, you can have many examples from WalkWe. So you can learn what is different from ESP8266. So there you have ESP32 plus DHT22 sensor. Let's see what different. Okay, they use it use different library, dhtesp.h, this library. Okay, let's try. Okay, this is working. You can change the value by using slider. Okay, for ESP32, maybe in the DHT library doesn't support ESP32, so you must search for different library that supports your MCU. For this example, fortunately, we have many examples in the WalkWe project, so you can learn from that. Okay, any question regarding DHT sensor? For ESP8266, use this library. It is okay. For ESP32, to use DHT ESP. It is a different library. You can check the support in the library manager. I will search for DHT sensor library. This is our library for ESP8266. You can click more info, and then you can read the documentation. Whether ESP32 is supported or not. Okay, but the documentation is very minimal. Okay. Okay, let's continue to our last sensor, distance sensor. We use ultrasonic distance sensor, SR04. It uses the sound reflection principle. So you have to pin trigger to trigger the speaker and pin echo to capture the echo. In this sensor, we have two speaker-like shape. The one is to transmit, the other one is to receive the echo. You can see the sensor is like this. The T is the speaker transmit. It will transmit the sound when the trigger is triggered. And then the R is receive. This is the microphone to receive the echo. And then if the echo is received, the echo pin is high. It will send the duration. The frequency of the sensor is 40,000 hertz. You can read it in this clock. The clock is unmarked. This is the clock, the component that provide the clock source. 40,000 hertz. Okay. For this example, I will connect the trigger to D7, echo to D8. We use these two pins. VCC to 5 volt. This device is working in the 5 volts. If you use 3.3, maybe in the operation will be unreliable, the reading. And then ground to ground. So this sensor needs 5 volt. Okay, I will set up the breadboard using this sensor. VCC to 5 volt. Hey. Black is ground, and then VCC is red. And then for data pin, you can use any color except red and black. because red and black is already for VCC and ground. This is the convention. So you, it is can be checked easily for VCC and ground. And then trigger to D7. Echo to D8. Okay. VCC ground 5 volt. Okay. Trigger to D7. Okay. Okay, for this sensor, we use new ping library to get our job easier. We use library, new ping. So we should install it in the library manager, search for new ping. There is only one, so click install. Wait until it is installed. Okay, and then we copy paste this program. Okay, I use define to alias pin D7 as trick and D8 to echo. And then I make an object for the sensor. The name is sonar. The parameter is trigger pin and echo pin. And then set up serial communication to see the result of the sensor. And then in the loop, we read the value of the sensor using ping centimeter. Ping centimeter. We use this function to read the value, and we save it to a variable name distance. And then we print the value delay for half a second, and then loop again. So it will read the distance every half a second. Okay, I will connect the MCU. And then upload the program. Okay, for the distance, you should check serial monitor or serial plotter. This is serial plotter. The red and blue is from temperature. So I will use serial monitor first. Okay. The distance is in centimeter. Okay, I can change the distance by using object. You can check the distance by using a ruler if whether it is accurate or not. So like this. Okay, and this is a sensor. You can move an object in front of it like this. And then you see the value will be changed. Okay, that is for distance sensor. If you want to make a 3D representation of your room, you can attach it to the like servo, so it will rotate and will scan your room from the distance. So you can reconstruct the room shape by using the distance plus the angle of the servo. Okay. For the simulation, this is still none. The SC22 at the SR04, this ultrasonic distance sensor, VCC to 5 volt. In this case, Vin and ground to ground. Trigger to pin. Let me check the conversion table. Any pin, digital pin is okay. For the sake of this table, I use 23 and 5 for trigger and echo. Where is 23? Okay, and 5. Okay, this is the hookup of the component, and I will paste the code here. This is 23 and echo is 5. Simulate. Okay, library new ping is not installed, so we should install this library first. New ping. This is easier in the simulation. Okay, this is the distance. This is maximum distance of 4 meter, 412 centimeter, 4 meter. We can change the distance by using slider. Maybe it is slightly less accurate. The offset is 6 centimeter, 12 centimeter. Okay, you should calibrate your sensor to the real condition to get the accurate result. Okay, that's it for the sensor. For the output, actuator, LCD, relay, DC pump, micro servo, will be tomorrow. With Bu Wulan, and for the connection for Wi-Fi will be tomorrow also by Pak Agus. Any question for the sensor? Not yet.
Pak Aurita.
Yes.
For the ultrasound sensor, from the monitor, it give the zero value. So what's the problem? The serial monitor, the value in the serial monitor is give zero, even though I put some object in front of the sensor, but the value is still zero. What's the problem?
What sensor?
Distance sensor.
Oh, distance sensor. Did you place it too close to the sensor?
No.
May you try to direct the sensor to the ceiling?
Oh, okay.
Because the sensor angle is very narrow, around 15 degree.
Thank you. Okay, thank you.
Okay. So if you block it unintentionally, it will reach zero. So for example, I have this object like this in front of the sensor, it may be reach zero. Okay, that's it for my session. I'm sorry if there is any mistake. Is there a microphone that runs in Python? There is. You can check it in the workbook using MicroPython. For example, Raspberry Pi Pico, it uses MicroPython. Let me. Raspi Pico. Okay, if you have any question, you can drop me an email to, I will type it in the chat. Or to WhatsApp. Because this is the hardware session, there will be many problems and many troubleshooting, whether it is software problem like installing the IDE or hardware problem. So maybe you still have a problem, you can ask me in the email or by using WhatsApp. Okay, that's it from me. I'm sorry if any mistake. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam.